Hello there and welcome to another wonderful episode of Iron Pod. It is proudly brought to you by Ghana Community Network Services, West Blue Consulting, and also Ghana Oil Company Limited. The media partner is Business and Financial Times. People, this week the entire port and maritime community is bidding farewell to one of its illustrious sons, that's the former Director General of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority. He bows out as the Director General of the Ports and Harbors Authority in this country. And Iron Port, we've been following him, following where he comes from, what he's been doing in the port, and this week we decided to chronicle his profile as the President, His Excellency Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, relieves him of his position.
Forgotten, but then she slipped into my pocket with my car keys. She said you're taking me for granted.
Richard Aburu Yinga Anamu was born on 10th October 1956 in the Upper East Region of Ghana to Mrs. Asibunu Anamu and Mr. Ayamga Anamu. Richard Anamu began his basic education in the Upper East Region of Ghana and continued to have secondary education at the Boko Senior High School in the same region.
I want to say that we from the Boko Secondary School, all students, we are very much proud about Richard Anamu.
He further enrolled at the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology to study civil engineering. Driven by his quest for ample knowledge and the desire to be skillful to improve his community and country at large, Richard Anamu further entered the Faculty of Law of the University of Ghana in 2002 and by 2004 obtained his LLB. He then continued at the Ghana School of Law in 2004 and by 2006 obtained the BL Barrister and Solicitor of the Supreme Court of Ghana and subsequently called to the bar. In addition to these highly acclaimed academic accomplishments, Ray, as he is affectionately called, has undertaken tremendous academic voyages, including obtaining a certificate in modernization of port facilities and management system in Japan, port planning, urban site planning and strategic information systems from Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT USA, in 1993. He is also a member of prestigious professional bodies, including the Ghana Institute of Engineers, Ghana Bar Association, and a fellow, Center for Advanced Engineering, MIT, USA. Richard Anamu became the civil engineer of Tema Port, responsible for all civil engineering development, maintenance, and supervisory works in the port. He also became the port civil engineer of the Takoradi Port from 1987 to 1995, where he was responsible for all civil engineering development and maintenance works in Takoradi Port. On his strategic vision and leadership, Richard Anamu, from a humble beginning in 1982, entered the company as a young civil engineer and has risen through the ranks to get to the pinnacle.
May he continue to chalk more successes. May he continue to make contribution as significant as he has made to our country.
He makes life a bit easier for you, for which reason the relationship might not necessarily be personal.
A young man, full of drive, strength. I mean, his strong desire to work. And he was also a brilliant boy.
He has seen the organization through various phases as a participant and ultimately as a head. A common description of Richard Anamu when you meet anyone who has had an encounter with him is a determined, innovative and zealous leader who through his all-inclusive management style has led a campaign to improve total efficiency in all aspects of Ghana's port operations. This vision of high efficiency and service delivery level permeates through various strategic decisions and directions. He's a team player who seeks to strengthen the bonds of respect and mutual support, building of strategic partnership with concessionaires, licensees and other stakeholders. Also, the utilization of various collective skills, knowledge and experiences to achieve strategic goals. Richard Anamu was also the chief port engineer of the Takoradi Port from 1996 to 1998, responsible for the overall engineering development planning of the Takoradi Port in the fields of marine, mechanical, electrical and civil engineering works, and the procurement of all engineering works and services by both selective and open tendering. Some major projects that were undertaken under the leadership of Richard Anamu in the Takoradi Port include the construction of a new local head office for Takrade Port, designed from a World War II structure used by the Ghana Navy as a store. At the time, previous port offices were in various rented premises. He also aided the construction of a new car park with offices inside the port for imported vehicles, a new plant and vehicle pool with open garages, a spraying bay, and offices. Richard Anamu also realigned water distribution system with lockable hydrants at the main wharf with the Corporation of Ghana Water and Sewage Corporation. He widened the main entrance to the Takrade port to cater for large-size cargo which use the port. He designed and constructed a new clinic for the port, designed and constructed new clubhouses for the senior and junior staff of Takrade port. He re-roofed almost all transit sheds in the port with design change in roof structure from north light to translucent sheets for illumination. Richard Anamu designed and constructed bridges and the road to Cape Three Point, removed rock outcrops on the road, and constructed road direct to the lighthouse.
He's achieved a lot in the maritime industry, internationally and domestically. A number of awards that GPHA has won over the period of under his stewardship. It's quite phenomenal.
He's a man of the mill. He's gone through a lot of challenges, and to have come this far, I can only thank the Almighty God for his life, and I can wish him the best that there ever remains for him for as long as he lives on this earth.
As project engineer of the GPHA headquarters from 1998 to 2002, he was responsible for the inception, coordination and management of the following principal works: study and dredging of Tema and Takrade ports funded by GPHA under writ of the Dutch government, study and design of the master plans for Tema and Takrade ports funded by JICA, study, design and construction of Quay 2 of Tema port equipped with container cranes under an Enclave Power Company contract, preparation of an estate development plan for the port of Tema, procurement of works and services for the above and the capital works, GPHA coordinator under the Ghana Gateway Project funded by the World Bank, institutional restructuring of GPHA into landlord port as the chairman of the restructuring team, study, design and supervision of the construction of second deep fishing harbour Takrade. Richard Anamu became the director of Port Tema from 2009 to 2012. As director of the Port of Tema, he had within 2 years turned the fortunes of the port, and for that matter the authority, from an almost bankrupt port to a financially viable port. He embarked on major rehabilitation works in the port, the provision of operational equipment, and laid the foundation for the expansion and efficient operation of not only Tema Port but also the Takrade Port. In 2012, he was appointed as the Director General of the Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority and notched up the expansion and rehabilitation of both Tema and Takrade ports.
When he believes in a cause, he does everything to ensure that there is a realization of that cause. He is affable. He's warm and he's hearty, and he's somebody I have worked with and whom I admire as well.
Ever since his leadership as the chief executive of the multi-billion dollar state-owned enterprise, Ghanaians have seen magnificent improvement in the management of Ghana's ports. Several development projects have been undertaken under his administration, which has been attested by many, including the first director general of Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority.
It has been fantastic. It's a great achievement. It's a great build-up. The capacity is great. I followed the progress very far, and I know I'm very proud to be associated with Ghana Ports and Harbors.
GPHA, as a state-owned enterprise, because it is an example of what state-owned enterprises should be. So with the new public debt management strategy, our intention is that all state-owned enterprises should be able to take credit on their own balance sheets to be able to implement their own developmental programs using their own resources. And I think that this is what Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority is doing.
Countless projects have seen absolute completion under the watch of Richard Anamu, including a new bulk jetty, a net mending wharf, a reefer yard, a transit terminal, consolidated revenue data collection center, and several equipment including about 10 mobile harbor cranes, security patrol boats and launches, tug boats and many more.
I quite remember one day there was a problem in the port, and we went to him, and immediately he left all that what he was doing and we went to the scene, and that baffles my heart
I feel very, 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 very happy. To have been able to engage Amiri, and God being so good, and he also working very, very, very hard for him to attain such a high level.
Another remarkable achievement of Ray Anamu is the construction of a fully equipped state-of-the-art international maritime hospital for the maritime community and Ghanaians as a whole. In addition to all his achievements, Richard Anamu successfully commenced the general port expansion project for both Takoradi and Tema ports. The Takoradi port has already seen the completion of an extended breakwater, completion of fabrication yards, and influx of oil and gas companies taking positions in the port to boost the oil and gas industry in the country. To cap all his achievement, Richard Anamu decided to embark on a very ambitious project to expand the port of Tema to almost three times its current size at a cost of $1.5 billion. Indeed, today, the ambitious $1.5 billion Tema port expansion project had already started with contractors on site.
So lifted the Tema port expansion from the drawing board to reality, which we are all seeing, that the contractors are on site now and they are working. If you talk about Takoradi port expansion, it has always been on the drawing board, but he picked it from there, and today it's a reality.
In addition, out of this project, slipways to ease traffic congestion at the Tema motorway roundabout has also begun and will be completed fully by 10th June 2017. Above all these, his quest to ensure transparent administration has seen him avail himself on various media platforms to answer to the people of Ghana progress within the port community. He has embarked on innovative ideas that have opened up the port's operations and activities to the general public. These led to the Port Authority being crowned the best PR organization for the public sector in Ghana and best campaign on integrity by the Institute of Public Relations Ghana. The ports of Ghana have subsequently continued to win a number of awards and accolades, both locally and internationally, including the best performing port in the Western Central African region. With all these achievements by one man for his country, his own compatriots can only adore him and wish him well.
I have no doubt at all in my mind that posterity will judge him as one of those who made a significant contribution to his country. I wish him God's blessings.
May God bless him and may God lift him up, because I see him as a gift from God to Ghana, and he's doing it through GPHA.
As a pragmatist who wants to achieve results, and indeed the ongoing port expansion project is one landmark project that he'll be remembered for in a very long time to come.
You need courage, Mr. God fearing. The toss for a humbrasier humility, and the toss for a juma day hard work. We now may come for more BBR. I'll be away. So, Hemo, no, Luciano.
Also, it's official, the former Director General of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, Richard Ewa Anamu, is no longer the DG. He bows out as the Director General of the Ports and Harbors Authority. In the coming episodes of Eye on Port, we'll be profiling some of the new administration, the Transport Minister Designate, for instance. We will be profiling him. We'll be having an in-depth interview with him. The Trade and Industry Minister, whose ministry directly affects the Ports and Harbors Authority and the maritime industry as a whole, we will be profiling him. And we have a solid interview coming your way in the next episode of Eye on Port from the Trade Minister, Honorable Alan Shermanting, plus a host of others. Will be talking to the finance minister, and hopefully in this week, if the president assigns somebody to be the new DG of the Ports and Harbors Authority, we will definitely be bringing you a close-up interview and a profile of that new Director General of the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority. All of these happens only on Eye on Port. We return after the break.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy.
I am sending a purchase order from S80 Ventures International. Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Appiah and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders.
Hey, Mama, what's going on? Catch it right? I mean, how?
Using single window, Mr. Appiah has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window, the only way to Ghana's economic growth, is in our hands.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with gold synthetic oil and any quality Goil oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with Goil synthetic oil.
We are a champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3 times world boxing champion and a patriot. Always. Choose Goil.
Ashine Pankasa. Goil. Good energy.
Welcome back from the break. Still watching Iron Port. Coming up next, news and activities that are happening in and around the ports and maritime industry, including our own partners, Ghana Community Network Services and West Blue Consulting, bagging loads of awards.
The Customs Division of the Ghana Revenue Authority, GRA, joined its counterparts around the globe to mark the 2017 International Customs Day. This year's celebration was targeted at how data analysis could be used for effective border management. A tax policy advisor at the Ministry of Finance, Dr. Labi Siang, who was the special guest of honor, indicated that with globalization, the trade and transport community continued to seek simplification of data requirements for international trade transactions on account of legal and regulatory regimes at the borders. He said there was consensus among member countries of the World Customs Organization, WCO, that global harmonization and simplification of systems and procedures could be achieved through learning from other countries.
It is becoming increasingly necessary for customs administration worldwide to share and exchange data and information. In Ghana, discussions are ongoing to interconnect the automated customs management system of Ghana with countries in the West African sub-region. This is to enable information to be shared and exchanged on goods transiting through Ghana to other neighboring countries.
The Commissioner General of GRA, George Blankson, said the Customs Division was moving on the path of modernization and intended to employ sophisticated equipment to make customs and border clearance easier and faster.
GRA continues to stay ahead, ladies and gentlemen, in the drive for innovation in ensuring better service for national development.
The CEO of West Blue Consulting, Valentina Minta, commended the Customs Division of GRA for its achievements in effective service delivery and revenue collection.
Recent successes, such as contributing significantly to improving Ghana's ease of doing business and logistics performance index, of the World Bank's annual rankings, we have no doubt that Customs and GRA are on the right path and the best is even yet to come.
The managing director of GCNet said GCNet will continue to deploy innovative ways to protect revenue data in Ghana.
To this end, GCNet will continue to roll out new innovative solutions such as GCMS-3 and a new dashboard reporting and data analytics software in the provision of e-solutions to modernize the processes of customs management to boost trade and revenue.
The World Customs Organization has awarded West Blue Consulting, the technical support providers of the Customs Division of the Ghana Revenue Authority, for its immense contribution towards effective service delivery and revenue collection in the country. The award was presented during the International World Customs Day 2017 ceremony, where the World Customs Organization, through its member countries and member administrations, award service providers and custom officers for work that has been executed the previous year. The award was in recognition of the Ghana National Single Window Projects for the Ministry of Finance and GRA and the launching of the Pre-Arrival Reporting System, PAS. 2 years ago, West Blue Consulting were privileged to be awarded this same WCO award in Nigeria for the hard work and efforts they exhibited to ensure that the ease of doing business in Nigeria was reduced. The CEO of West Blue Consulting, Valentina Minta, was optimistic that Ghana will see a significant improvement in the ease of doing business.
We're very proud to be a part of the group recognized this year. It shows that the right work is being done. There are a lot more challenges to overcome, but at least it shows that we're in the right direction. Now, 2 years ago, we were privileged to be awarded this same WCO award in Nigeria for the work that we did on the efforts. So as an African company, we're very proud to have worked with two of the beacons of Africa, Nigeria and Ghana, and to be awarded internationally for the work that we're doing. Because we believe together with other service providers, with government, with importers, exporters, transit operators, together we can put Africa where it should be and certainly Ghana on the map where it should be.
The Ghana Community Network Services, GCNet, has been awarded by the World Customs Organization for its contribution towards trade facilitation in Ghana. The WCO gave GCNet the award at the International World Customs Day 2017 ceremony held in Accra. The managing director of GCNet said they are humbled by the award and revealed that his organization has lined up a number of improvements and enhancements that will be deployed in the course of the year to improve data in the country.
The very first ones will be in the first quarter to start rolling out the Ghana Customs Management System version 3, which will bring a lot of improvements, especially when it comes to mobile data, mobile applications, mobile devices. So that will be a strong improvement. We've also increased the security and the tightening of the system itself so that there is far less abuse possible. And that will be one of the major deployments that we will do today.
He said GCNet will also be working closely with IBM in the field of business intelligence and data analysis. Meanwhile, GCNet has held its fourth Thanksgiving service to appreciate the goodness of the Almighty God for a successful 2016. The Thanksgiving service was attended by management and staff of the company who danced in appreciation to God and prayed for a fruitful 2017. The executive chairman of GCNet, Dr. Note Omabo, urged staff of the company to adhere to integrity, teamwork, humility, and service.
Teamwork is biblical. We have to stand by each other. And humility always comes when you've had a good year, and it's in human nature to feel arrogant and proud and complacent, and I would like us to eschew that from GCNet. Integrity is important, especially in the environment in which we are. And I charge all of you and I pray that integrity prevails in everything that we do.
The leading oil marketing company in Ghana, GOL, says it will continue to remain the benchmark in the oil marketing industry in the year 2017 by adapting the right marketing strategies in spite of stiff competition that lies ahead. The group CEO and managing director of GOL, Patrick A.K. Akoli, in an interview with Iron Port also said the company expects more growth in the economy this year.
This year, economic activities will boom. And then it will reflect on the sales of GOL. But GOL itself is preparing. As we said, the last four years have been quite interesting for GOL. We've been working hard day and night to reposition the company. We have stations now all over. In almost every district, you find GOL.
He revealed that the marine gas oil tanks being constructed at the port of Takoradi would commence operation in March 2017, aside the MGO tanks at the Sekendi Naval Base. He assured that GOL will improve the bunkering business in the country as several vessels are expected to call the port of Takoradi.
We want to be part of the upstream industry too. So the first step is to be the providers of MGO, marine gas oil to the upstream industry. All the ships that will come and dock at the Takoradi port. We have put up wonderful facilities, storage tanks over there now, which will start operation by March this year.
The MD of GOL also disclosed that GOL will commence the construction of a bitumen plant in Tema in March, which is expected to be completed within 18 months.
Bitumen constitutes a very, very important part of road construction. If you are not in control of bitumen, all the bitumen that we get in our roadworks are imported, you know. So if we are in league with SNB, like Cote d'Ivoire, you know, they have a refinery, they are going to do the refining over there, but they will throughput to GOL facility in Tema. And then this will reduce the cost of bitumen in this country.
He said issues of health and safety and integrity would be at the core of GOL's services.
We know that the consumer pays a lot for fuel. So why would he have to go to a station and then be cheated? Double agony. So we are imparting it, we are impressing upon our dealers. Integrity is the watchword. So that when drivers drive to our stations, they know that they are going to get the right quality and the right quantity.
Patrick Akoli said GOL will continue to add additives to its products in order to make sure that the efficacy of its products is improved at no cost of the consumer. He hinted of GOL's intention to expand to the West Africa sub-region, adding that with the right leadership, GOL will become a multinational trader.
Hello.
Good morning. This is Samantha Wendy. I am sending a purchase order from SAT Ventures International. Our policy for new supplies is 2 containers to start with, but you must deliver within 30 days.
Don't worry at all. I'm going to get you the 4 containers within 30 days or less.
Bye. To get his pineapple slices from his country to his clients overseas, Mr. Appiah and his representatives have to complete a number of regulatory compliance procedures to various international trade stakeholders.
Hey, Grandma, what's going on? Catch it, right? I mean, how? Hey.
Using single window, Mr. Abia has completed all his international trade procedures through one portal. He has registered his company information, applied for the necessary permit, certificates and licenses, and all that remains is for him to get a text alert for clearance and movement of goods. And that's how simple facilitating international trade could be in a single window environment. You can offer competitive services to your trading partners in China, America, even here, in a simpler, faster, and cost-effective way. Single window. The only way to Ghana's economic growth is in our hands.
When cleaning your vehicle by valeting, steaming, waxing, or polishing, make sure the engine is also sound. Servicing your vehicle with GOL synthetic oil and any quality GOL oil massages the engine, removes deposit, protects it from wear and tear for longer lasting performance, and makes your vehicle fuel pumped. Made for diesel and super engines. Remember, after every 15,000 kilometers of enjoying your ride, service your engine with GOL synthetic oil.
We are a champion. That's why I, Azuma Nelson, 3 times world boxing champion and a patriot. Always. choose Goel.
Ashine Pankasa, Goel, good energy.
Schedules of vessels that are sitting in the port, those at Anchorage, those expected in the coming week, plus the Bank of Ghana exchange rate next. So, in addition to the profiles of the incoming administration, including the Trade and Industry Minister, the Transport Minister, the Finance Minister, the incoming Director General of the Ports and Harbors Authority, we will also, or we are already pursuing some of the complaints we have received from the some of the clients, the importers and exporters who do business in the ports and maritime industry, particularly this one who says he imported about three cranes in a 12 40-footer container that he can't find. Also, this one who says he imported Nissan March for his grandmother and that can no longer be found in the port. We'll be dealing with all those issues in the coming episodes of Iron Pod. That should be it for this edition. Thank you for watching the program. Also, thanks to the crew, Robert Nyantechi, Godwin Kabute, Michael Fumi, our new driver, very wonderful and helpful driver who assists the entire team. Also, Solomon Anderson, Joe Lavoie, the executive producers, Paul Asariansa, and Abner Sewa Opokufosu. Flavia Muesi is my colleague who supports the program big time. Thank you for watching.